In this vlog, we are going to see how to send an in-app message to our Flutter application using OneSignal. So previously, we have seen in-app message using Firebase. In this particular tutorial, I'm providing the link in the description section below. And now, we are making use of OneSignal to send an in-app message, which looks similar to that of our previous tutorial, but here we are having more number of options as we are making use of OneSignal. Yes, as we go through this particular tutorial, I'm going to show you what are all the different options we have in sending in-app messaging, and I'm pretty much sure that you would be opting OneSignal instead of sending in-app message directly from Firebase. And yes, of course, OneSignal is also making use of Firebase, but it is providing us a very good user interface so that we can make our work as simple as posting an image on Facebook. Yes, but the output will be very much effective than you expect. It's not any basic output, but it's like a very professional output you will be getting by making use of OneSignal. And also, the one more major advantage of why people use OneSignal is, like, with the help of API, you can send push notification, in-app messages, and also configure deep links to your application as well. So Violet, let's get started with this particular tutorial and try to see how to send an in-app message. And also, I suggest you to watch till the end of this particular tutorial because the concept is very simple and very easy. I just want to show you all the required steps you need to make and also the available options in sending in-app message. So now let's get through the console first. So this is our OneSignal console through which we have sent push notifications and also deep links previously. So this is the particular message which we sent last time for push notification, and almost we have covered all the features available here, but there is one more feature, like Android action buttons. So this particular thing is having some technical issue currently, so we are not going to cover this particular action buttons in this tutorial, and in coming tutorials I will try to cover this particular topic as well. Just let me know in the comment section below if you are interested in implementing the action buttons. So now let's get started with in-app messaging. So this is the in-app message tab available here. And when you tap on this particular in-app message here, you will be provided with some, by default, some basic templates here. So these are the basic templates with which you can get started easily. And when you tap on this particular template here, it will be loaded up for you. And within the actions, you can tap on duplicate here. By tapping on duplicate, you can just try to edit the available template and try to send this particular template to the audience. So now, instead of editing this particular template, why not get started with a complete new message so that we can explore all the available options in-app. So the very first thing is, like, message name. You can also save, you can also create a template of your own. So this I'm just naming, like, first in-app. And by the end of this template here, you are having an option like save as draft. So this particular template will be saved by this name, first in-app. And also you are having an options like show to all users, show to a particular users, that is segments. So how to create a segments and what are the segments and how we can create segments. So I will do an in-detail tutorial on this particular segment topic. Just let me know in the comment section below if you are interested. And here the second option is like message. How do you want to design your message? So there are two options provided for you. First one is a block editor and the second one is a HTML editor. So in the start of the tutorial, I just said you, right, using OneSignal, you are having more options and it's easy to use as well. So when you tap on HTML editor here, you will be provided with the code option here. So you can just write the code, like, and you can also see the output on the right hand side, like how the in-app message will look like. So if you are having a good knowledge on HTML, you can just get started with this particular block of code. And as this is a basic tutorial, I'm going to cover block editor. So block editor is nothing but the basic way of customizing our in-app message. And just let me know in the comment section below. I will also try to show an example like how HTML editor works if you are really interested and want to try it. In the block editor, we are being provided with some basic options like, so how you want to position your in-app message in your screen. So the first option is top here, and when you select top here, it will be like a top banner in your application, and center, bottom, and this is a full screen. And again in full screen, you are having two options like with margin and without margin. So with margin looks pretty much good for me. And let's try to select full screen here and also with margin. And here in the text, I'm going to specify Flutter app. And in the fonts, I'm going to select Fira Sans. And for format, I'm going to select bold here. And whenever you select any particular option, you can see like your screen is getting reloaded on the right side, so that you can get the exact output like how it looks in your mobile application. And the color, black color is good for me. And font size is, you can just select anything. I think 24 is better. And text align is also center, it works for me. And here even you have advanced options like margin to the top, right, bottom and left. You can specify margin to all the sides of your particular text here. So by default it is like 0, and you can just specify them if you require them. So here I have specified 100, so my text moved from top by 100 pixel here. So in this way it works, but for me by default 0. And here image, you can also add an image over here, and this is a default image added by OneSignal. And you can also add a click action for your image. So whenever user taps on this particular image, what action needs to be performed, like do you want to open a URL or you want to push a permission prompt. Like in general, when you are dealing with the application, there will be a permission prompt, like so in this way, a location permission prompt. And also you can add a custom action ID, and with the help of this particular custom action ID, you can define your own functionality in your app level and make it work. Okay, so I'm going to select URL here, and also you need to specify URL in this particular format here. You should not miss HTTPS or anything like that. And I'm going to specify my website here. And as we have already selected URL here, so we need not again reselect anything. And for this particular block also, we have advanced options, which is just like margin on all the sides and also dismiss on click. So I'm not going to select this particular dismiss on click for now. And here we also have a button which is not visible here, but yes, there is a button also here. So I just want to make the button margin like 100 here from bottom, so that my button will be just below the image. And also for the button, you are having various options like click me. So let's make it get started. And also font Fira Sans again, and remaining all the things are pretty much perfect. And close button. So here we also have a close button, and you can just add height and width for it. So the button looks good, and also just make it like 10 and 10 only. And here also we have got some advanced options like margin. And finally we have got background here. So what is the background color currently is like white color. You can just make it any other color as well. So let's go with white color itself. And also you have got an option like portrait or landscape. So these are all the various options when you are making use of OneSignal here. So for now, portrait is my requirement. So, and these are the triggers. When should user see this message on app open? When certain conditions are satisfied? And again, what are these conditions? So we can just specify some conditions like when the user is in particular screen or particular action is performed. So we'll be discussing them more in a detailed tutorial. You need to just let me know in the comment section below, like what part of the tutorial you are very much interested. So I would be making a separate tutorial on it. So in this particular tutorial, just I want to cover all the basic aspects and try to get the output so that you will understand the basic functionality, and in coming tutorials, we can implement much more things added on this particular basic functionality. And when should the message dismiss? Show until dismiss. So this is the best option, and dismiss after a certain amount of time. And you can also specify this if you just want the message to be displayed for a particular amount of time. So I'm going to stick with show until dismiss, and these are all the schedule options. Now I just want my message to go immediately, and you can also specify some time. So sometimes there will be offers in your application, so you can just specify the time exactly, like 12 o'clock in the midnight, so you are just going to start this particular offer. And in the scenarios, you can just specify specific time here, and also you got stop showing time here. So you just want the offer, or you just want the in-app message to be displayed only for 1 day or 2 days, or within a time range or within a particular range. You can just specify them accordingly here. And how often do you want to show this message? This is also based on your requirement. If you just want to show only once, you can just specify once and every time. And now we almost reached the end of the template here, and I'm going to send this particular template now. So send test in app, and this is my device, and I'm going to send this particular in-app message. And here you can see we have got our in-app message as quickly as we tap on the send button. So here, this is our in-app message. Just like we have specified the margin, with margin we have got it. If we have not specified any margin, it will be full screen there. And here for the image, we have specified URL, right? So let's try to test it. I'm tapping on the image and it is opening my website here. And let's get back to our application. And now when we tap on get started, our in-app message dialog will close. So now without margin, let's try to send the same message and try to observe our emulator. So here you can see we have got a full screen of our dialog here, and let's try to tap on the cross button this time. And let's try to see the center one now, how this looks like. And yes, center is also pretty much good. And you try this top and bottom options on your side, and just let me know if you are facing any issues, because in top and bottom we don't have that much area here. And you can see we have just got text here, and image and button is missing. So just try to customize this particular thing according to your requirement. And on the code level here in our application, we have not additionally added any code here, as we have just initialized one signal and we have sent push notification deep link in our previous tutorial, right? So the same code we are making use of it here, because our app is being recognized by one signal console, so we can just directly send push notification, in-app message. And also in coming tutorials, we are going to see email, SMS, these particular options as well. I mean, if you are interested again. So yes, this is it for this particular tutorial on in-app messages using one signal. So for more interesting tutorials on Flutter, stay subscribed to our channel.